Trust it.
Hey everybody, Dr. O here. In this video, we're just going to do a quick overview of the anatomy of the urinary system. So we've covered the physiology, the function of the urinary system in a separate video. Let's go ahead and just, so we won't cover everything on here, I guess I can briefly do it, but we're going to start with the kidney. And you can see that the renal arteries, they enter the kidney and carry blood to the kidney. Renal veins are going to carry the blood away. They're entering and exiting an area of the kidney called the hilum, just so you know. But the kidney is going to be where urine is produced. We'll cover the internal structures of the kidney in a separate video, and we'll cover the microscopic structures, the actual nephrons, the functional unit of the kidneys, will be covered in a third video. So lots of detail here in the kidneys. But just right now, imagine the kidney is this magic box where things are taken out of your blood, put back into your blood, and urine is produced. So that's going to be the job of the kidney, to produce the urine. Then we have the ureters. So the ureters are two 12-inch hollow tubes full of smooth muscle that use peristaltic waves of contractions about every 30 seconds or so to milk urine as it's being produced, milk it from the kidney down into the bladder. So that's the job of the ureters, to carry urine from the kidneys to the bladder. You usually don't even know you have ureters unless you would get a stone trapped in there, and then you will definitely know that they exist because of the pain. Then we see the urinary bladder. So the bladder is going to be for the temporary storage of urine, and then for micturition, which is urination. It's a domed structure full of, it has three layers of smooth muscle, just like your stomach does. It has folds in it when it's empty called rugae, just like your stomach does. And its job is to temporarily store urine until it's time to urinate. And then we'll have the micturition reflex or urination. We'll cover that in the video on the bladder. But it's going to involve the relaxation of smooth muscle and skeletal muscle while the bladder contracts, and that's how we micturate or urinate. And then we have the urethra. So we go from the kidneys to the ureters to the bladder. Now we're at the urethra. The urethra is going to be for the passage of urine from the bladder to the toilet or to wherever. When we talk about the urethra, the main thing we talk about is how the female urethra is so much shorter and straighter that it's much easier for fecal contamination bacteria to get into the urethra, which is why women are much more likely to have urinary tract infections. All right, so that's just a real quick overview of the key function of each of the parts of the urinary system. I didn't mention the pelvic bones there. We covered the arteries and the veins. And then lastly, the adrenal glands. We covered them with the endocrine system. Remember, the adrenal glands, also known as the suprarenal glands, they sit on top of the kidneys and they produce hormones. Okay, that's a quick overview of the anatomy of the urinary system. I hope this helps. Have a wonderful day. Be blessed.